In this tutorial video, we'll talk about the basics of creating a motion tween in Animate CC. The first step is to make sure you have a named layer. Each object that wants to be animated needs to have its own layer. Then we need to add an object. In this particular example, we're going to add a star, so I'll choose the polystar tool, go to options, change the style to star, and you can change the number of size and the star point size to get some really unique stars. For right now, I'll just leave it the traditional 5-point star with the fill color of yellow, and I'll start at the top of the stage and just to the left of it. I'll grab my selection tool and highlight that object and move it over a little bit so we can see it. Make sure that object is on the correct layer. If it's not, undo it and place it there again, or cut it and paste it. Once you have that object selected, and I'll do it again just to be sure, go up to Modify and choose Convert to Symbol, or use the keyboard shortcut of F8. We want to change this to a movie clip symbol because it's not a button, it's not meant to be clicked. So we'll go ahead and change this to movie clip. And I like to name my movie clips starting with MC, so it's a visual indicator that it's a movie clip. And this is the first star I'm creating, so I'll name it star 1, just like the layer that it's on. So those are coordinating. We'll go ahead and click OK. And now that that object is a movie clip, it's kind of grouped together, so it's no longer a merge drawing mode where you can kind of destroy it and break the pixels apart. And it's ready to have a motion tween. So with the object selected, we'll go up to Insert and choose Motion Tween. It's going to automatically add at least 1 second worth of frames. Because my frame rate is 24 frames per second, it automatically added 23 more frames, including that first frame I already had, to equal 1 second. Now, if you wanted it to last longer, you could stretch this out or bring it in if you wanted it to last shorter. That's up to you. So in the starting keyframe, you can see we have this black dot. That means that the star on frame 1 is on the left side of the stage. Move your playhead to where you want the star to travel in time. So I want to say by 1 second in, the 24th frame, I want my star to be on the right side of the stage. So with that playhead in place, I'll grab my object and move it to the right-hand side of the stage. Notice when I did that there's another keyframe dot now on the 24th frame, and you should see a motion path if this is in fact selected. This means that it created that tween for you and moved it from the left to the right and created all those frames in between. So that's the basics of creating a motion tween. However, there are a couple of things you should know. First, if you hover over the motion tween, you can see that your mouse has an arc next to it. That means that you can change the path so it can curve. You can also use the direct selection tool, click on the end of each of these, and be able to change the handles so you can create more complex curves. Last, the motion tween implies that the only thing that it animates is the motion, left, right, up, down, diagonal. That's not true. It can actually animate many different properties. The types of properties it can animate can be scale, rotation, it can add filters like a glow or a drop shadow, it can even change colors from yellow to pink to green because it's now that movie clip symbol. If you're interested in seeing more about this, look at my YouTube channel and search for movie clip or motion tween property animations, something of that nature. Now, let's see this again with a new star, just to review this motion tween process. I'm going to lock down the first star layer and unlock the second star layer. That's something you should get used to when working in Animate CC, is being able to lock it down to make sure things go where you want them to go. I'll choose the polystar tool. This time I'm going to do kind of a hot pink. And I think I'll change my star settings to maybe have 10 with spikes of 0.3. So when I drag that out, it gives me a totally unique star. And again, the process is to first create that object. Let's move it where we want it to go. And then we need to go to modify, convert to symbol, make sure it's movie clip, MC, star 2. Now, you could choose graphic symbol. There's another tutorial I have on my channel on the difference between movie clip and graphic symbol, so make sure you watch that. In general, we want to do movie clip unless we know it's a button. It's something that we want to click and have an action happen. This isn't going to be a button, so we'll do movie clip. Okay, so once we've converted that to a symbol, again, we have to go to Insert, Motion Tween, and then move our playhead in time. So if we wanted this one to kind of ping here and then come here, we can do two different directions by putting our playhead halfway through the motion tween. And by this point in time, we can move our star here. And then by this point in time, let's say we want our star to move off. So as you can see, it had a change in direction, and all I had to do to get that was change where my playhead was in time. The trick with this is that let's say we don't like where this keyframe is. Maybe we wanted it to be a little bit earlier, a little bit later. In order to do this, you have to click off of that motion tween and then click once again so that only that keyframe is highlighted, and then you can click it and drag it around. If you want to extend or shorten the time, you can click and drag in this nature. But just be aware when you do that the keyframes also change their original position to sort of keep the balance that it originally had. Next, if you actually want to drag this entire tween out so that the yellow goes first and then the pink goes second, you can highlight by clicking or clicking and holding shift and then clicking the last frame. And now you can click and drag and stagger that animation. So what's going to happen now is the yellow star will curve through, and then the pink star will do a pyramid, and then we could have something else happen on star 3. So that's how to create a basic motion tween in Adobe Animate CC. Make sure you watch that video on motion tween property animation so that you can see how to rotate, change the glow, scale, all kinds of different property animations instead of just the motion of the motion tween.